My friend Robert Cypers, together with his band Northwoods Revival, stopped by the other afternoon for a chat and to play a few songs. They have a show at Garden Plaza of Greenbrier Cove. That's on Forsythia Way in Collegedale. They'll be there Thursday evening, starting at 6.
Sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. Sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. Ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees and bells and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. Now Christmas cookies are a special treat. The more she bakes, the more I eat. Sometimes I just can't get myself to stop. Sometimes she'll wait till I'm asleep. Take the ones that I didn't eat. Put them little sprinkly things on top. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. The ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees and bells and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. Now, those sprinkly things just make things worse, because it makes them taste better than the first, and they're absolutely impossible to resist. Some disappeared, who knows where, but I make sure I get my share, and the kids just have to wait for the ones I miss. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. She gets mad when they're all gone before she gets the icing on. Sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. Now there's a benefit to all of this that you might have overlooked or missed. So let me tell you the best part of it all. Every time she sticks another batch in the oven, there's 15 minutes for some kissing and hugging. That's why I eat Christmas cookies all year long. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. The ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees and bells and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe.
I'm down with that.
Come and visit with us.
Why don't you introduce everybody, Robert?
Okay. Over here in the radio world that you can't see, but here, Linda Price. She does vocals and melodica. Hmm. And Deborah Orban next to her, she does upright bass and vocals. And back over here is Joel Sullivan. He does the cajon. And I'm Robert Cypers, and we make up Northwoods Revival, name of the band.
Been playing together very long?
Linda, what? 3-4 years? 5? Linda and I started. So, yeah, been a few years.
You have nice harmonies.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That was just happenstance? Have you been working on them a lot?
I think the people that I'm working with here make that happen. We feel like that, you know, our best offering of what we do is our harmonies. Linda is a vocal teacher, a voice teacher, and teaches piano. And so she's probably the big part of what brings us together on our harmonies and such. She helps us a lot with that.
So how's Robert? Is he a good student for you?
Oh, definitely.
You're right.
Oh, yes, yeah.
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 He already knows everything, but yeah. I just kind of nudge him here and there. You know?
I don't know about that.
Who chooses the songs?
We kind of mix it up. I would say somebody will bring a song. A lot of our stuff is cover songs. And again, we try to make it eclectic, a variety of music. I like to think folk Americana is kind of our genre. But everybody brings, you know, hey, I'd like to try this song, and they'll take the lead on it. So we mix up the lead a lot in our songs. So it's a good mix of everybody bringing what they find of interest and like to do. And our crowds, the places that we play a lot, I would say would be older community, seniors. We try to also make our music fit to what they would find of interest.
So songs they recognize.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, why don't we have everybody introduce a favorite song? Let's start with you, Robert. What's one of your favorites that you guys do?
Of ones that we sing or just...
Mm-hmm. So you can play it, you know?
Yeah. Well, we do have one original song that we do that I wrote a few years ago that I guess would probably be one of my, I don't want to say favorite, but I enjoy doing, I guess,
well, let's because do that, of that. Then. Let's do that.
You want to do that? There's a story behind this song. It talks about getting old, Richard. And so, you know, there's something you have to come to grips with. But where it all came from is you have to, getting old will lie to you. It will pull the wool over your eyes and will not really tell you the truth of what's going on. And I'll give you an example of that. Here a couple of years ago, I went to go get a haircut. And normally I would go to the same place, see the same hairdresser. And I went there that day, had an appointment, 2 o'clock. And got there, and the girl at the receptionist said, Elaine is not here today. The lady that normally cuts my hair, she's not here. So you either got a couple of choices. Said you somebody here, somebody that's already here that you can get a haircut with, or reschedule with Elaine. And I said, well, I like the idea of getting it done, so let's do that. So they brought me back into the salon. There was a young girl there. And we kind of went through the basic conversation and decided what that, and put the old, that black cape on you, tighten up around your neck. And she started cutting my hair, and then she asked me a question. She said, did your hair used to be red? And it caught me off guard. And I thought, what's she talking about? What is she talking about? And I just kind of blurted it out without even really thinking a whole lot. I said, well, I thought it was. And she said, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to embarrass you. And I said, I know you didn't embarrass me, but you probably told me something that I haven't been paying attention to. So after the haircut, I went straight home. Went to the bathroom, turned on the light, and looked in the mirror, and she was right. My hair used to be red, and now it's gray. So that's what happens. Every morning you get up, you look in the mirror, you don't see those subtle changes that's happening to you until you get your hair cut and somebody asks you a question like, did you used to be young? So that's where this song kind of got it started, called Sit Awhile. This old house I'm living in is starting to show its age. Its bones don't stand so tall, and the color's beginning to fade. The wind blows right through, and the rain is mighty cold. I guess that's the way things are when you're starting to get old. I think I'll just sit down underneath this here old tree. I promise I won't be a bother. I got friends there waiting for me. I used to be just like you, always had a busy day. But I'm a lot slower now, so I think I'll just sit down here. I get tired easy and my thoughts just jumble around. I sometimes wonder if they'll find me in the lost and found. My evening skies are growing dim and my sun heads to the west. I think I'll take its lead and find my place to rest. I think I'll just sit down underneath this here old tree. I promise I won't be a bother. I got friends there waiting for me. I used to be just like you, always had a busy day. But I'm a lot slower now, so I think I'll just sit down here. This next verse is about a little story about my dad. Drive south on Seminole Street in a West Texas town. And under the shade of the tallest elm tree, my daddy could be found.
sitting in his homemade Adirondack chair, smoking on his pipe without a worry or a care. I think I'll just sit down underneath this hero tree. I promise I won't be a bother. I got friends there waiting for me. Used to be just like you, always had a busy day. But I'm a lot slower now, so I think I'll just sit down here for a while.
What do you like about getting older?
It, you kind of get a little peace about just life and just say, well, you know, in the struggle, you don't have to struggle as much. You accept some things. So it's not too bad.
I'll go along with that.
Yeah.
There was a poet in here the other day, and she said that growing older is much like the trees. At this time of the year, they lose all their leaves. You can see them more clearly. I think it's also true that you can see yourself more clearly when you get older, you know?
Yeah.
We have fewer illusions. You think that's true?
Yeah, yeah. I read something the other day, and it's, well, actually, it's a little sign I got stuck on my wall. It says, embrace the mystery and explore learning. And I think the embrace the mystery, a lot of questions we all have in life, and, you know, why this, what's happening here, why is that happening? And some of it's just a mystery. You can't really come up with answers for it. But you learn to kind of live in that realm of the mystery is just a part of life.
Do you have a favorite song that you do, Deborah?
Sure. Yeah, I do. We do one that I normally play some up on at Mountain Opry with my husband some. And I have one that we do with this group called Catfish John. And the reason I like to do this song is that it has two aspects of my childhood that it reminds me of. One is it's about hobo. And when I was a child and my grandparents lived all their lives in the Smoky Mountains, there was a hermit that lived down the road. And my grandmother used to always tell us kids not to be going down there and hanging out where the hermit lived. And we were never afraid of him or anything, but this song is reminiscent of that time for me. And another portion of this song, it talks about cotton fields being white as snow, and my other side of the family is from southern Arkansas near Mississippi, and it's all cotton fields. And so there, as a child, I would run through the cotton fields at my grandfather's chagrin because he didn't want us in his cotton fields. But we would sneak out there, and we would think the next property was just 5 minutes away when it was actually miles away because the land was so flat. But this song reminds me of my grandparents from both sides of my family, so that's why I love this song. It was originally done by a country artist called Johnny Russell, and then Alison Krauss made it famous. Yeah. And I won't pretend that I can sing like Alison Krauss, but like any of our other songs, we have our own style as Northwoods Revival, which I really enjoy, and we make all of our cover songs our own. So we'll do Catfish John.
Cool.
Mama said, don't go near that river. Don't be hanging round old Catfish John. Come the morning, I'll always be there, walking in his footsteps in sweet Delta dawn.
Catfish John was a river hobo. He lived and died.
in the town of Vicksburg, traded for a chestnut bear, never spoke a word in anger, though his load was hard to bear. Mom said,
those harmonies. Northwoods Revival, our guest this morning, Robert Cypers, sings and plays guitar. Linda Price adds a second harmony. Deborah Auburn adds a third while playing bass, with Joel Sullivan playing the cajon.
Kind of an interplay between the two of you is what that is, right?
Yeah, I follow her and she follows me.
You two are kind of a piece. So what about a song, Joel, that you ever...
Well, I like all you of like? Them. I kind of like the way we do Knocking on Heaven's Door. And we do Can't You See by Marshall Tucker. I like that, too.
Knocking on Heaven's Door, Can't You See? Either one of those sounds good to me. How about you?
Yeah. All right. Let me switch over.
We can do something else. It doesn't matter.
I really like that song, Can't You See? It's a great song.
You were talking about how we all met, and it made me remember that Robert, I guess we met during a play we did, Signal Mountain at the Mac, that Tom Brown wrote. We were both members of the cast and in the band for Fat Shirley's Trailer
Fat Shirley,
Park.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so we met there. And then later we were in another band together called the Campfire Girls with Trish Wyman.
Sharon Schwab.
Yeah, Schwab now. Dave Schwab's wife.
Sharon's married to Dave. Okay,
right.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
so we let go of that band. And I heard that they were playing together, Linda and Robert. And I invited myself.
I don't know if that's the way it was.
I did. I invited myself. I said, hey, you could probably use a bass player. So can I come and play?
I think that makes us unique.
I think that's true. As far as Fat Shirley, I think Tom has become an international celebrity
because
of that play.
He has. And yeah, I performed in that same play again 2 years ago with my husband. My husband was in the play too, playing the banjo. But my husband and I performed in that play again in Fort Oglethorpe at the Colonnade. Yeah. Weren't tortured enough the first time.
Ready?
Woman been doing to me.
Can't you see? Can't you see what that woman been doing to me? Gonna find me a hole in the wall. Gonna crawl in and out for that lady, mean old woman. She never told me goodbye. Can't you see? Can't you see what that?
You done. That was a nice vocal on there, Robert. That song has gospel roots by the sound of it. That's not apparent when you hear those guys sing it, you know, but when you hear a song like that.
Yeah, it's got some, I don't know, some kind of soul, some deep element to it.
It does.
And how it does that, I don't know, but you sing it, a lot of people our age and somewhere around in that time will sing along with you. You'll see people singing it.
Oh, you know it.
Yeah.
I mean, that thing was all over the radio for a long time.
Yeah, yeah. And a very, very simple lyric and idea. And the melody's pretty simple, but it's got some depth to it. I don't know how it happens.
Well, I think a lot of the depth is in the vocal, and you caught that. But the harmonies, too, really add to it.
Yeah, I think, yeah, the way that the chorus comes in with the harmonies on it, it's pretty makes it pretty interesting.
So what's your favorite song with the band, Linda?
Well, the first two songs that we ever did and recorded was Sit Awhile and Leaving on a Jet Plane. And I love trios. I've always loved the trio sound, or even a quartet. I mean, like a woman's quartet, like the Carpenter sound and things like that. I've always loved that sound. So I always loved Peter, Paul, and Mary when I was growing up. And so I thought, I'm so glad we did Leaving on a Jet Plane. And we do have a video on YouTube with us doing it, in addition to hearing it. That's one of the songs that's on the EP.
Would you care to do that?
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah. If you're up for it.
Yeah.
I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. The taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could cry. So kiss me and smile for me, tell me that you'll wait for me. Like you never let me go. So many times I've let you down. So many times I've played around. I tell you now, they don't mean a thing. Every place I go, I think of you. Every song I sing, I'll sing for you. When I get back, I'll wear your wedding ring. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go.
Would you care to close with a Christmas song? You got another Christmas song you can play?
Yeah. You want to do...
You've been practicing those, haven't you, Robert, the way you said that? I could tell.
Well, we've tried to
come up with some ideas what would be best to present, you know, other than the what's on the EP. Linda does this one here that's an old traditional we'll do.
I do the first verse, and
yes,
Deborah does the second verse.
Yeah, that's true.
One thing I love about our band is I love their voices, and we all enjoy singing and playing together, and it helps that we're friends and like each other. You know, I mean, it really makes a big difference, I think, on how we sound.
I would think so. Yeah.
Yeah.
It becomes a part of the music that you make, doesn't it? How you feel about each other.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. The chemistry.
City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style. In the air there's a feeling of Christmas. Children laughing, people passing, meeting smile after smile. And on every street corner you'll hear
silver bells, silver bells. It's Christmas time in the city. Ring-a-ling, hear them ring. Hear the seals crunch, hear the kids munch. This is Santa's big scene. And above all the bustle you'll hear silver bells, silver bells. It's Christmas time in the city.
You guys are going to be a hit. You're already in prime, aren't you?
We rehearse a lot.
That was fun.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having us.
It was my pleasure.
To be with
treat.
The icon and legacy of Richard Winham is exciting and nervous too. So.
Oh, there's nothing to be nervous about.
Northwoods Revival. They will be at Garden Plaza of Greenbrier Cove for a concert on Thursday evening. Garden Plaza of Greenbrier Cove is at 4586 Forsythia Way in Collegedale. The show starts on Thursday evening, December 16th at 6 o'clock.